It is a fallacy to say that you can examine the Christian faith, the person of Jesus Christ, scientifically. Because to be proven scientifically, it must be related to a measurement, a phenomena, an experimentation, and repeated over and over again observation. We must make observance of an event being repeated over and over, and then you draw the data from it, and you take an hypothesis that's been stated and you prove it empirically. This cannot happen in most people's lives or events of history. For example, try to prove scientifically that Kobe Bryant was a great basketball player and received the MVP award. You can't. You can't repeat that in a controlled environment, observation made, data drawn, hypothesis empirically verified. And yet almost everyone believes that Kobe Bryant was a great basketball player. Or that Barry Bonds broke the home run record. Now, most people believe that, even though it's questionable and is on the ethics of it, and yet you can't prove that scientifically because you cannot repeat him doing it in a controlled environment, observation made, data drawn, and hypothesis empirically verified. You say, well, you have video you can play over and over again. Well, that's not the scientific method. That's the evidential historical method. Or try to prove that Tony Dungy was coach of the Indianapolis Colts in the National Football League. Now, you probably believe that. Most people in America believe that. But you can't prove it scientifically because you can't repeat it in a controlled environment, observation made, data drawn, and hypothesis empirically verified. I was at Stanford University, and I just finished speaking on the resurrection. And I walked down front, and I was interacting with a lot of the students and professors. And this one student spoke up, and he said, I'm a graduate student of science, and I cannot believe in the resurrection because I cannot believe anything that I cannot prove scientifically. I said, now, that is amazing. And you're a graduate student? You can't even prove your own statement scientifically, because you can't repeat the exact same statement in a controlled environment, observation made, data drawn, and hypothesis empirically verified. What you can prove scientifically is actually very limited historically. We must apply the evidential historical method when it comes to a person or an event in history.